Hey guys, Janette Barber, Daily Woodie, Central Park. I am so freaking tired today. Last night I drank too much, I ate too much, and I had a panic attack. But I mean, other than that, it was a great night. The panic attack was not directly related to the virus, although I suppose it was indirectly related, because I was supposed to have FaceTime drinks with my sister, thus the drinking too much. And so then she's texting, why aren't you picking up? I'm going, well, because you're not calling. I check my little settings, because I'm very good with all technology. I check my settings. It's, you know, go ahead, try it again. And then I suddenly realize I've got no wifi. And I don't panic, because again, I know. I just go right to my, there's no Wi-Fi there. My Wi-Fi channel isn't even showing up. Well, it's probably just a problem with my phone. Everything is probably fine. So I decide instead, I'll go check the TV, because I have a smart TV, because I used to have a moronic TV, but the Liebenzettschitzgefahrte decided I needed one with intelligence. So he got me one that is on Wi-Fi, so I have no TV. I've got no TV. I've got no Wi-Fi. I've got no TV. Oh my God, something is happening. Something has happened. What am I, but you know, I'm holding on here, because I think, you know, it's probably just an outage. There's probably an outage in the neighborhood. So I immediately call, completely not noticing that my phone does still work, because, you know, I've got the, you know, Verizon, you know, I don't know how many G's are involved, but there's a lot of G's here now. And 4G, whatever the hell it is. Anyway, so I call Verizon, and, you know, I get one of those automated robot voices. And on a side note, I'm beginning to think that everybody you call is a robot. I think there's a perfectly good chance that there are very few of us left. And it's just on TV, it's like a loop of humans, so that we're being fooled. And most of what's left are data's children from Next Generation. This is what I'm thinking. I'm not positive. Sabrina Rude, let me know. Star Trek friend. But anyway, the automated voice, I call up, let me check your account. And then the robot goes, oh, it does look like there is a problem. I'm going, oh my God, now there's a problem. And they go, we may have to send someone to your apartment. Oh, that's a great idea. Send the cable guy with a toolbox filled with virus. That's exactly what you want. What am I going to do? And, or you can just pull some, unplug it. You can unplug it from the wall. Well, who can find the wall in my apartment? So I've got to move furniture, because if you saw the Absinthe Live, that big wooden armoire thing, that's my desk, and you open the doors like this. So I got to move the chair, the giant copper planter down underneath with the power strip with 5,672 things plugged in it. I don't know which one it is. Now I can't just pull on it and see, because the door of the armoire, this is a two-person job. There's only one. I'm here by myself. I am by myself. There is no minnow. I am Gilligan. And I got no skipper. I am completely alone now, alone in the world with too many plugs. What am I gonna do? So then I think, I look at the power strip, but I say, there's no switch. There's supposed to be an on-off switch. There's no on-off switch. This, what's wrong? Then I think it's the plug in the wall. It's gotta be the plug. Probably the power, maybe the plug blew. So at this point, I'm working myself up, and I gotta test it. I run to get my hair dryer, but my hair dryer plug is the wrong shape of what. So now what am I gonna plug in? There's nothing, but yeah, a floor lamp. What am I gonna do? Move a dressmaker down? So I find this old bottle lamp with a bare bulb, but the power works. Oh, this is even worse. This is worse. I can't call Mike, my super, who I don't think would bring a toolbox of virus into my apartment. Now I don't know what to do. Everything is working. So I pull something out of the back of this, what do they call this? Modem. Because the modem, I have secreted this modem behind the giant monitor as if it is Anne Frank and I'm trying to save it. So I can't see it, I can't find it, and I don't have a flashlight. And the thing, at this point, the phone rings, and it's the Liebenzettschitzgefahrte. So I answer the phone, and I said something, I don't remember exactly, but it was something like, I don't know what to do. Oh my God, I can't see. I have no TV. Oh my God, I can't call anybody. I'm completely alone. You know, cable guy virus. And I'm completely having a meltdown. And then I say to him, I've got to get off the phone because I'm having a panic attack. And then I proceed to refuse to let him get off the phone, lest he should, by accident, be having a good night. he's got to stay here while I continue Meltdown. And he says, incredibly calmly, he goes, well, you know, maybe you should see whether you should try turning the power on and off on the power strip. There's no switch. There's no switch on the power strip. There's really nothing here. I can't make it work. I can't make it work. I can't plug the back thing. I can't see. I can't see. Now, I've taken the lamp with the bare bulb, and I'm sticking the bare bulb in the back trying to see. I don't know if you can see the burn. So now I burned myself. I'm having a panic attack. I refuse to listen until all of a sudden I hear him. When I'm having a panic attack, I will often hear 3-4 minutes later. And that switch, there should be a switch. So I go back to the power. Okay, there's a switch. Now, I couldn't see the switch because the light was off, because it was turned off. so that's embarrassing. But I also realized that it could not have been me that did it, because the power strip is behind the armoire, behind the giant planter, and behind a chair, all of which I had to move to get it, which means the cat did it. So I'm definitely planning to have them put down, you know, as soon as I get a minute. And maybe I'll have them stuffed, so I'll still have company. But Suzanne McCabe, my cat nut friend, knows I'm not going to do that. But you know what? I am going to threaten them. It's, you know, it's not a matter of a manipulation. It's actually, it's a matter of power. And sometimes you need to exert that, you know, over, you know. And they were probably sitting back there laughing, going, you know, if she's going to hold out on the cat, yep, we're going to ruin the Wi-Fi. But in that moment, the idea that I'm just going to be in this apartment with no contact to the outside world, a complete and total meltdown. So, and then when I go to bed, I pass out is actually what I think I happened by the time that happened, that I woke up at 4 o'clock. Oh, and that was the other reason. I didn't have Wi-Fi, and I was in a blind ass panic because I had stuff that I had to get to my agent this morning, not this afternoon, this morning. And I don't have a computer. I don't have a thing. I can't be done on the phone, all of it. So it was kind of a draining, you know, last 24 hours when you come to think of it. But you know, no matter how dark things get, there's always a bright side, and this was mine. Look at this. Did you notice this? This is a bracelet that my soul sister, Lynn Cohen, hey, sister, go, sister, soul sister, sent me. Of course, I had to spray the box with, you know, Lysol, microwave it and scrub it down with a broom and soap. But inside that box was this, and it's Morse code. It says, soul sister, hey, sister, go, sister, soul sister, in Morse code, which I think is incredibly cool. And, oops, the wind is blowing. And it really cheered me up. And I also thought it could be handy to know Morse code if this happens to me again. Because then I could always go to the window and I could open it up and I could, you know, just yell, dot, 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 dash, 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 dot, dot, dot. That could be, you know, very, very helpful. Dot, 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 dash, 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 dot, 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 to the street below. And I'm sure that would be a big help. So thank you. Hey, sister, go, sister, soul, sister. Oh, and I've got more good news. My mustache trimmer is on the way. So, well, I hope it's good news. I'm not entirely certain it's going to get here in time for me because tonight's a full moon. So there's a very good chance that by 10:30 I'm going to be howling out the window and running around the room on all fours. So, you know, on the upside, maybe I can find myself a nice peacock to snack on here in the park. So if you are in New York and if you notice a werewolf with an unsightly mustache and a French beret, that's me. So don't shoot. You know, save the silver bullets. Make them into earrings. I think that would be a very good idea. You know, it's good. I'm 66 years old and I'm turning into a chicken sucking circuits geek, but it's good. It's good. I'm fine. Don't you worry about me. I do not need Eddie's meat thermometer. I'm fine. I just want that to be completely, you know, dot, 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 dash, 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 dot, 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 clear that there is no problems here, because I got a hey, sister, go, sister, soul, sister. Yeah, it's all good. Dot, 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 dash, dash, dash. Share it if you like it. See you tomorrow. Dot, dot, dot. Dash, dash, dash. Dot, dot, dot.